I don't know, I did not realize it that by baking for home will become a full-fledged business and I'll become a successful entrepreneur. And you know, one day it just dawned on me that destiny is not made by the shoes we wear, it's just by the steps we take. So. Hello everyone, you're watching me on The Dispatch. I'm Renukaa Modi and I would like to just tell you, give a message from my side as to what I have been, how I've become today as to what I am today. Well, I started from home, my baking, which was just a hobby turned into a business. And I don't know, I did not realize it that by baking for home will become a full-fledged business and I'll become a successful entrepreneur. And you know, one day it just dawned on me that destiny is not made by the shoes we wear, it's just by the steps we take. So if you should have the resilience and determination to reach the shore, life is not smooth. Like the way I have been baking, I have been like making different things, and to go on about doing your business is not a smooth venture. What with so many responsibilities, and it's like, you know, like you are tossed about like on the sea, like with the rough tides and the waves, but your focus should be on the shore. When you have the grit and determination to reach your destination, I'm sure you can do anything what you want to. We women do have the potential to do anything. We only don't use our potential. Woman is very precious, very fragile and radiant. She is like a jewel. She can do anything. You're not only just strong, ambitious, you can do anything. You're beautiful. You can do anything. It's just that I have been just like working at night, in the middle of the night. I've been working day and night. I've had a lot of problems. I've had a lot of health problems too. But then, you know, there was that, I just updated that quote, that beautiful quote by Robert Frost. It was, "The woods are lovely, dark and deep. I have promises to keep, but I have miles to go before I sleep." You know, when that quote I updated it, it was like my health started going down and I became so down and depressed. I was wondering whether I'll be able to carry on or not. But I was so blessed with my family and with my friends that they really motivated me. And then I started really feeling, no, I should now like start again, because in the middle of this, all this, I had stopped like making so many cakes and all. I was just like wondering whether I'll be able to carry on or not. But no, I, with that determination, with the motivation, you know, you have to, that talent, you have to use that talent which God has given to you, which we don't use. At the end of the day, like, at the moment when I'm standing in front of God, I would not like to say that I've not used that talent which you have given me. I would like to use it to the fullest. So this way, like I have been making cakes, I've been admired also for my cakes. My family is really happy with my success. But I think without family and friends, you just cannot go on with your like these commitments and all. I've done a lot of commitments, I've been doing, and even till now I'm doing so. Well, I used to make the cakes for my family, for my in-laws and for my husband, you know, because they were very fond of it. And yes, it was because of my I think I had that talent in me because of my mom. She used to make lovely cakes. And I think like I was quite tired of just entertaining, you know, just for my friends and everything. I wanted to do something, but I could not do it. So it was just at the instance of my friends that my husband was persuaded that to let her make cakes for the friends. So it started from home. And then gradually by word of mouth, I became a name by the name of Renukaa. And then after that, I was really like, you know, like appreciation really encourages you. It motivates you. You want to do more and more. And it's not just for the, what I feel, it's not for the money. It's for your like satisfaction you get. Like you really, you feel like yes, you're doing something. Constructive, like you, you feel something constructive, that you're doing something. And I feel all women should do it. Like they should really not leave any potential in them. We have everything in ourselves, but we just don't do it. So I think we should do it. And gradually by doing it home, at home, I started then, I opened this outlet in Gandhi Nagar at Renukaa. And by the grace of God, I did well. And yes, there's a lot of competition too. I have a lot of competition. And I feel one, I don't compete with others. I compete with myself. I'm self-critical. I don't criticize others. Like if you have your feet on the ground and you're humble, I think you can do anything with your determination and do it humbly. You can do anything. Like when I got married, I was too young and I did not know anything, how to make anything. So like my husband and family were very good, very fond of food. So what I thought, okay, let me just start making something or the other. I started making, and my husband being a bureaucrat, like he used to entertain quite a lot. And my family was full of like, it was like a political family. And my father-in-law would be inviting the cabinet, the whole cabinet, and a lot of ministers would be coming, you know. So I'd be just entertaining them and but it was very much appreciated. So it was quite, I liked it, like entertaining. Yes, because you know, say that Renu bahut acha banati hai. It was like Renu ne bahut acha banaya hai. So you know, you get so much encouragement, and when you are young, you really do get encouraged, and you have the energy also to, you know, to do anything, whatever is told to you to make and everything like that. I'd be working day and night, you know, to anybody like would come. We are coming to your house, and I would just say, "Haan, main bana dungi." So I would make whole lot of 8 to 10 dishes, you know, and put them across. And everybody, even my husband would be quite surprised, that banaya kab isne kab banaya. But I had that energy because small kids I had, but I did it. Because why? Because it was my passion. You know, not only to make cakes, I would be like passionate about every cooking. Like Chinese, I would make intercontinental, but then continental khana, anything what I'd be doing. I was you get in a josh, too much josh into it. And I would never get tired, you know. I think I'd be just wanting to make my, you know, cooking and whatnot in the kitchen, and I would not find it stressful. You know, like it, I would find it more stressful if I was in the bedroom. I would be like more happy in the kitchen. So, but it was nice that my husband's like colleagues and my husband's like bosses and all were very happy with my baking and their wives and everything. So, I think this has really helped me become a baker, because if it was not so, I don't think I would have been a name today because of the encouragement. And yes, he's the biggest critic. Like he would criticize my cakes, ye theek nahi hai, wo nahi hai. So I became perfect also because of that only. And yes, it was like it was not easy doing a business also, because since my husband being a bureaucrat, you know, is not used to like having like those, you know, we have a way of running the administration. Like I had those difficult times while having these my, you know, the people, my staff and everything. Like you cannot do with rope se to kar nahi sakte. So he would say ke inko aise karna hai, inko aise karna hai. So I would say no, you have to have a soft, you have to be a little soft on the staff. You cannot, these are not the subordinates, you know, of the government thing, where you can just order and say ke aur wo kar lenge chup chap karke. So it was a little tough for me, for a bureaucrat to have a wife who's running business. But we learnt how to deal with it and how to deal with our staff. You know, it's not easy being from a bureaucrat family, and then but I am basically from a business family. But it's like this.
What changes it brought in you, the professional?
Well, I was a very, very, I feel, I had not so much confidence, naturally. I was just a simply housewife. With this change which I got, I became a very confident, a very ambitious and a very focused woman. Focused on the shore, focused on my work, and determined to become something. Like even now I feel I have in me to do quite a lot. I would like to do it. I don't want to. I have my dreams. I have more of my dreams to do more and more. By God's grace, if I can do it, I will surely do it. Well, I would just like to tell the viewers that don't envy your friends. Make them envy you. Like I know I have my husband. I'm financially sound, but it's not that. Sometimes you want something. You don't want to just take a katora and in front of your husband and just say ke mere ko ye le ye dono ye chahiye wo chahiye. Why do you always have to ask your husband to buy you something? I think you should. You have the potential. Why don't you do it yourself? I think everybody has some talent, or God has given us a talent. Why don't you all use it and become financially sound yourself? It's not that you're not dependent on your husband. Husband is there, your family is there. But why do you have to always ask for everything, and why do you envy people? Yes, like I would just think that, oh, that woman has this thing and that thing. I would not envy though, but I was just saying to myself, my husband is providing me well enough, but I would like to buy a few of my fancy things on my own hard-earned money. So what I did, I had that thing in me. Thank God I had it in me, and I think you all have it in you. You can do it. Don't have it is difficult to start something, but I started it just with this. It was by chance God gave me that thing to use that talent. Use your talent. Make yourself independent. You can earn good money. And I think with you yourself doing something constructive, you can get that confidence in you. You can be independent. And it's not that you're going to be like, say, I'm independent and yes, and to your husband. No. You have it in you. Do something which you can become really a successful person. And don't envy. Make yourself do anything or the other. Yes, but hard work is involved. Yes, I have sacrificed quite a lot. Like I've had to hear quite a few things from my husband also. Like there was a cake order and I have to go somewhere for dinner or a lunch with my husband, and I'm getting late. My husband wants to go in time, but I'm not able to go in time. So there would be a few tips between us both. But then you have to do, I know it is difficult, but then you have to just tell your husband, yes, I want to do something. I have to do it. I have to give my commitments. So I used to give my commitments and then go. You know, even in the middle of the night, sometimes I worked till 2 o'clock. You know, early in the morning, I would get up to do my gigs. Ab koi soche ki meko kya zarurat hai karne ki. It's just because of my, I wanted to do something. Like, it was not koi majboori to nahi thi. It was not a, like, it was not a compulsion that I do something. But today, at least, I feel, now anybody says to my husband that your wife, some people know my husband by my name. So, he doesn't mind it. Like, he likes it, he's quite amused by it, that he's known by my name. So, ab unka time tha, yes, I was known by his, as his spouse or as his wife. But now, I think people know him by my name. So, you feel it's a proud moment for husband and family. Because even my children also today, they feel so good and so proud that their mom is doing something. And I think it's a good feeling, you really feel more confident more and more. And I think you can do anything financially, you're sound because you can do something. You can't do just sitting, doing nothing. Do, move around. You have to get out of that comfort zone to do something. You just can't sit and go for parties or just like the way some women do. Yes, some women do it. Like they go and just you spend money on their things and you know, just whiling away the time. I think one should be a little constructive.